You still have to think about what the other players are doing, which are central banks right now, the players. So until they don't stop pumping liquidity, I don't think there's an end to this.
So Jan Marc, welcome back to the studios.
Hello.
Now, as we see, this week has started with the Monday morning. Bitcoin was fast approaching the $10,000 mark. Now, the big question looms over Bitcoin and other cryptocurrencies. Is it just an asset bubble that is waiting to pop?
Well, it's difficult to say if it's an asset bubble. It's definitely a speculative market and that needs to be regulated. So that might be the trigger that will pop the supposedly the bubble. I think the market is getting, you know, hysterical about this. It is one currency that they're trying to develop, and I think there's too much euphoria. We hear all day long retail clients or even institutional clients trying to get into the Bitcoin, but it's a difficult to invest in a currency or any asset that moves 20-30% in any given week or day. We're up 800% year to date, so I think there's a lot too much euphoria, and some people might get their dreams shattered coming soon.
Absolutely. Now moving on to central banks. So you believe that central banks adding liquidity to the markets may provide some risk for other asset classes regarding actually creating a bit more of an asset bubble. So tell us a little bit more about this. What's your thoughts?
Well, we all thought from the beginning during the crisis in 2008 that the central banks were an important factor in helping the recovery and getting liquidity to the market. But now, after more than 8 or 9 years, all the central banks are just pumping liquidity, and pretty much the whole market is just moving on that. When you have Bank of Japan, you have a Swiss National Bank actually investing in equities, it justifies the role of a central bank. A central bank is here to give liquidity to banks, but not to invest in the actual market. So I think that that amount of liquidity, and given the size of all the balance sheets of the central banks, it's going to create bubbles. Some may say that equities are going into a bubble. Commodities probably would be the next asset to look at, but something has to give. Either the growth is okay and we can raise interest rates, but the central banks cannot go and pump liquidity constantly into the market. Makes no sense.
Yeah, absolutely right. And now it's time for the million-dollar question. So we've mentioned that sometimes if you fear that you are in an asset bubble, 2017 has been a big year for cryptocurrencies and for a lot of the markets. If you fear that things are going a little bit too high and that you may potentially be in an asset bubble, for the investors out there, what kind of risks can they assess? How can they protect themselves from this?
So it's really hard first to find bubbles and to actually time the topping process. I would say that to not use leverage, to refrain maybe from investing in some bubbly like we just mentioned. But I would say just accompany the move, but not being leveraged and not be overextended and not think that prices would just keep on rising forever. So probably not a time to be short, but not a time to be leveraged on the long side in the markets. I think an equilibrium can be found between 45 and 50% equity exposures, and the rest can be used as cash as a buffer in case there's a pullback or in case there's a drawdown where you can put some more money to work. But you still have to think about what the other players are doing, which are central banks right now, the players. So until they don't stop pumping liquidity, I don't think there's an end to this.
Absolutely. Well, Jan Marc, thank you so much for coming in today and sharing your insights with us. Well, that's all from us here in the Geneva studios, but we want to hear how you found this interview, so please do like and comment on dugascopy.tv.